Okay, so after reviewing the footage from yesterday's video, I realized that right at the end I made two fatal mistakes. Mistake number one, I had my amulet of magic missiles equipped instead of my amulet of imminent return. So even if I did unfreeze, I would have just fired magic missiles instead of escaping. Two, right before I died, one of the wraiths that had me boxed in disappeared. And at first, I was like, why did that happen? Why did the wraith just die without me being able to hit it? And I remembered that when you have a negative plane protection cast on yourself and you are hit by an undead enemy, the undead enemy takes a little bit of damage. And in that situation, the damage from the negative plane protection killed the wraith, and I would have been able to escape with my life had I been paying attention. So these are valuable lessons that I will need to remember for the future. Also, the way I let myself get boxed in was really dumb. And yes, throw the key at the lock. That's how it's done. And if I had been paying any attention at all, I would have realized that I was about to get trapped. It was a little risky just attacking it again after my negative plane protection expired, but I ended up okay. Alright, so, let's see. The shield's still not better than the shield I have. Let's go ahead and eat these rations I just picked up, so I don't have to create food and water right off the bat. I'm not discouraged, though, because this is a difficult game. I wasn't expecting to beat it without dying, and if I did, that would probably be pretty boring. So, you know, you have to take the bad with the good. So I was talking about the Elder Scrolls series. I mean, I don't hate it. I see the appeal of the games, and I can definitely, especially back when Daggerfall came out, I can see why that was so beloved by people who played it at the time. But I don't really think any of the older Elder Scrolls games aged that well. Why did I come in here? I don't need to do that. And the newer Elder Scrolls games, I just don't find that appealing. I don't like the way the skill system works, how you have to do actions to level up that skill. I don't think it's fun to do that. I much prefer the skill style in the Fallout games. And I mean, as far as Bethesda RPGs go, I really love Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. And if Elder Scrolls worked like those games, I would probably like them a little bit more. But I mean, that's not my only issue with the Elder Scrolls games. Skyrim specifically, I was not able to get invested in the story at all. None of the characters were really that interesting. The setting wasn't really interesting to me. I've always been more of a sci-fi nerd than a fantasy nerd, especially like post-apocalyptic stuff. So I'm sort of predisposed to like Fallout. So that might account for that. But I don't know. Oh great. Yes, Duke. Step into the little alcove that allows you to get trapped by the Zill. Brilliant combat tactics. But yeah, people who dig Elder Scrolls, I can definitely see why. It's never really been my thing. I was going to try out Elder Scrolls Online before the beta ended, but I signed up for a beta key, or beta access too late, I guess, and never received a key. Which, I mean, I don't really like MMOs either, so I wasn't expecting to like Elder Scrolls Online, but I thought I'd at least give it a try. If it goes free to play, which sadly is kind of what happens to most RPGs these days, then I might give it a try at that point. Or most MMOs, not most RPGs. Alright, we are resting pretty frequently, so I can keep myself protected from the negative plane. I wonder what the in-game justification for the level drain is. Like, what exactly is the negative plan? I have no idea. Alright, let's see if I can go 5 minutes without resting again. Probably not. There are a lot of wraiths running around. Oh yeah, that's that brigandine I couldn't wear. There are a lot of Zills. Just a colony of Zills up there. And I'm held. Great. See, the bad thing about the enemies being able to respawn is that, I mean, I could be just in a normal hallway like this, and an enemy can just appear behind me, and I can get trapped without really being able to do anything about it. Doesn't happen very often, but it happens. Oh yes, the horrible stench of the troglodytes. I've heard all about them. I see you, Wraith. Man, I don't know how they turn around so quickly. Like, I try to sneak up and get a quick shot, you know, while their back is turned, and they just kind of immediately, oh shit, just kind of immediately windmill around and react. Alright, I think I still haven't done anything that I haven't done in the last video. Oh wait, there it is. Couldn't find the bone key when I had to. Yeah, I was just about to go in here, or I had just gone in here when I got trapped. Alright, going to have to pay more attention to my mini-map. And where exactly the red dots are. Because, really, I died in a very silly way in the last video. That was a preventable death. There are unfair deaths in this game, but that was not one of them. Like, if the first time you ever play this game, if I was playing this for the first time, and I read a book and went insane and died instantly, before I could even, you know, figure out what the books did, I would have been pretty peeved, especially if I hadn't saved at the time. But I guess people who were used to roguelikes would have known what they were getting themselves into. Not that roguelike was a term when this came out. At the time, this was just known as, like, Eye of the Beholder meets NetHack. And I don't really know how much mainstream appeal NetHack had at the time. Alright, here's that strength draining zone. Hey! I want to talk to the hand. I don't care if the face doesn't understand. I'm getting confused a lot too, because I think my hammer is killing enemies on the way back. And I'm not realizing that they're dead, and I'm looking around to figure out where they went. Alright, this was right around the place I got trapped last time. So it's time to buckle down and pay attention. Alright, still doing pretty good with my health. Don't have to worry. Oh god, my strength is 3. Great. Man, that is... Now that's unfair. I mean, I don't know if my strength is really affecting anything, because I still seem to be able to hit these guys most of the time. But if I was using, like, if I was using a sword or using a melee weapon, then that would probably have a serious effect on my ability to hit. Pretty sure it's only because I'm using a magic throwing weapon that I can hit these guys at all with a strength of 3. Hey, jerk. Why don't you get hit in the face by a hammer? That's a pretty good insult. You can use that one the next time someone cuts you off in traffic. Or the next time someone parks like an asshole. Hey, you. Why don't you get hit in the face by a magical flying hammer? Granted to a holy warrior by an angry god. It's kind of like Thor's hammer when you think about it. Oh, wow. That was a Minotaur. Alright, Minotaur, how do you feel about a spell I don't have memorized? Oh god. Alright. I'm about to get held. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring up my spell list. Cast Cure Serious Wounds. Ah, I was hoping that would the cooldown would take effect while I was inside that screen. Alright, I'm gonna get out of here. I'm in a bad situation. I know that's a coward's way out, and I apologize. But better to live and fight another day. Wow, that's a great thing to start the level to. I think I'm gonna stay up here and rest a little bit first. Oh yeah, that's right. I still have Cure Critical Wounds. That's why I didn't have the Flame Strike. Okay. Alright, time to get another Create Food and Water. I'm glad the coast is clear up here. Because if there are monsters up here too, well, they would have been weaker monsters that I would have been able to deal with more easily. Alright. Create Food and Water. You know, the usual routine. Okay, I have my Flame Strike now. So once I get back to that Minotaur, he's in for a world of burn. It might be worth taking another negative flame protection instead of prayer. I don't know how much good prayer is doing me. Alright, remember to equip my shield this time. And away we go. Oh, you know what? I should have ready Flame Strike to hit these guys. I bet it would be super effective against undead. Alright, I was taking a risk there by not casting negative flame protection immediately, once again. Maybe I should stop taking so many risks. The shield does seem to be helping me a pretty good bit, though. That extra bump to my armor class, or whatever the opposite of a bump is, since it lowers it. I was going to say, what's the opposite of a bump? But going by road sign terminology, that would be a dip. Maybe there's an Earl of the Dip out there who is my exact diametric opposite. My nemesis that I don't even know exists. If you're out there, Earl of the Dip, haha, you're Earl of a Dip. That's really dumb. Nobody likes dips. At least bump can be used to refer to something good. Like, oh, I got a bump to my paycheck this week. But I mean, there's no good context for dip. Unless you use snuff, I guess. Well, not that snuff is good, but if you are addicted to the nicotine content of smokeless tobacco, then you probably have good associations with the word dip. I mean, I guess, you know, potato chip dip is good. But, you know, that seems like a different kind of dip to me. I don't think potato chip dip would be under the jurisdiction of the Earl of the Dip. Oh, great. Man, they are strategizing. They're trying to box me in. Or maybe it's just a coincidence that the AI worked out that way. I'm held. Great. I should have looked up Zilds before I started this video. See if they have any weakness I should be aware of. Not that I'd be able to, like, I wouldn't be able to cast an ice spell. Well, I do have a wand of cold. I kind of forgot about that. I kind of don't want to use it against these, you know, relatively weak enemies, though. I should save it for the Minotaur or other higher level denizens of the dungeon. Or dungeons, as people shouldn't call them, because that's a really bad portmanteau. Alright. Why isn't this door opening? It must be locked from the other side. I don't see a button around here anywhere. Well, I have plenty of options. Oh, I bet if I just go up this hallway, I'll be able to unlock this door. Dungeon layout seems to be getting more complex the deeper I go. Wait. Yep, there it is. And another key. Oh, okay. It wasn't locked from that side, but there was a button on that side. Man, it's a really good thing I don't need strength for anything. I wonder if putting a gold coin in one of those slot machines gets rid of the strength effect as well. Or if that's just status effects. I don't know if the reduced strength counts as a status effect or not. What's that, a rock? Well, hopefully it's not a magical rock because I'm not taking it with me. That looks like a good place for a garnet. Boy, there's sure a lot of enemies on this dungeon level. It's almost like this game is a brutal roguelike dungeon crawler from the early 90s. That tries to whoa! That dude just stepped through what I assume is an illusionary wall. Ooh, an ion stone. It's the first one of those I found. Yep, there's the illusionary wall. Well, let's see what this sucker does. Okay, it's not cursed. Does not seem to affect my stats. Ion stones are weird. You equip them and there are three slots, and I guess they're just kind of circling around my head. I don't know what effect the ion stones have. I haven't really looked into it. Well, hopefully it's not something bad. Although, if it's not cursed, then I'm assuming it's not going to be anything bad. By the way, in case you were wondering, the reason why I don't just use Remove Curse on the book is because it doesn't affect the curse status of items. Protection from electricity. Well, that might come in handy. All Remove Curse does is make it so, like, say I had a cursed helmet that made my armor class that increased it by 2. Because remember, a higher armor class is bad. By casting Remove Curse, I'm able to take that helmet off, but it still has the plus to the armor, so it still has the bad effect, but you can just remove it. See if this is far enough away from enemies to rest. Good. It's pretty generous. I think if there's a monster within 5 squares of you, it won't let you rest, but it's pretty easy to get out of range. Aw, man, I should have gotten something else instead of create food and water, since I don't need that right now. Oh well. Hey, buddy. Also, I don't really need that detect magic, but I'm not really using my cure light wounds or anything. Man, I'm kind of nervous thinking about. I mean, I'm only on level 5, and there are 18 levels in this dungeon, and I've already died. I was hoping to last a little bit longer than level 5, so things are going to get pretty rough. If I start dying a lot, I might go back on my policy of only saving at the beginning of levels. It might be necessary, as much as I don't want to do that. If it's a choice between that or dying over and over and over again, then I'll go with the save scumming. Because of the two options, I think that dying over and over again is the less entertaining option. I don't know, unless you want to see me die over and over again, chime in the comments, I guess. I mean, I know people like watching people play Dark Souls because it's fun to watch someone struggle and die over and over and over and over again. I have a terrible memory. I look at my map and then 2 seconds later, I forget which way I needed to go. What? Oh. That might be the Minotaur making that noise. That was a really unpleasant noise. It didn't sound like a monster. It sounded like just a recording of a guy throwing up. Or maybe that was the sound effect in the music. I don't know. Luckily, the Zills... Yeah, that must be the Minotaur. The Zills don't have any kind of ranged attack or anything, which is nice. Man, there's still a bunch of enemies in here. The Wraiths don't have a ranged attack either, but they have that, like... Seems like they can attack you from a square away. They have, like, some sort of reach effect. Or 2 squares away, rather. In D&D 4th edition, it's just an ability called reach. It means you can attack something 1 square away. Usually only monsters have that, but some weapons players can have give them reach, and you can have reach 2 and reach 3 and stuff. I might as well cast that negative plane protection before I rest again. Since I have it memorized. Is my strength still... Yeah, still pretty bad. The water in this basin does not appear to be healthy for drinking. Well, that's a surprise, considering it's been stagnant in this decrepit dungeon for the last 1,000 years. Great. Oh, no. I did it again. Alright, which of these is the Amulet of Imminent Return? It's this one. Alright. I mean, there's no point in trying to get out of here because I'm just going to get held again. So my best bet is to try to escape before I get killed. I might get a level drain before I can escape. It sucks, but yep, loses a level of experience in all spells. Please just unfreeze. Please. I should have cast Crave Food and Water. Oh wait, I forgot to pray for spells again anyway. Okay, well. I'm not, maybe I should cast Invisible to Undead. It might be a good one to use against those wraiths. I'll keep a couple Cure Light Wounds. Alright, still not discouraged. I've almost completely explored level 5, so all I have to do is finish that out and kill the Minotaur, and then I'm done with this level. Of course, it's only going to get worse from here. But, you know, that's the fun of it. Alright, Cure Serious Wounds. Don't really want either of these. And I lost a level of experience, so I no longer have access to my level 5 spell. Great. I had to rest for 16 hours to memorize all those spells. That's kind of nuts. Okay. The usual negative plane protection. Not sure how much of a difference that invisible to undead is going to make. Because, I mean, I become visible as soon as I attack, I think. I think that's how invisibility works. I know if it was just general invisibility, then, yeah, as soon as I attack, I would no longer be invisible. So I'm not sure if it's, well, it's, my portrait is still grayed out, so maybe I can attack and still be invisible to undead. Of course, it's possible that if I attack an undead creature, then I become visible to that creature. I'll just have to wait and find out. Well, the Zills definitely aren't undead, whatever they are. Which I didn't think they were, but that is now confirmed. God, these things are fast. I can't even get away from them. Maybe I should start getting Cure Paralysis. Well, I mean, you can't cast spells if you're paralyzed, though, so there is no... Is there a Cure Paralysis spell? Or is it just protection from paralysis? Remove paralysis, but you can't cast a spell if you're paralyzed. So I don't know what the point of that is. That's weird. I mean, it would make sense in, you know, an actual D&D game, because you're in a party, and, you know, if one person gets paralyzed, then the cleric in the party can cast remove paralysis on them. But there's no way for a cleric to cast remove paralysis on him or herself. So I don't know. Wow, just a huge, huge cluster of monsters down here. Okay. Man, I'm going to have to go all the way around. That sucks. Maybe there's a secret passage in one of these walls. It's worth a shot. I mean, since there are no monsters here in this area, I'm free to explore a little bit. I don't think I'm going to get that lucky, though. Maybe I should learn Cure Paralysis and see, like, maybe they fudged the rules a little bit, so if you're a cleric, that's the only spell you can cast while you're paralyzed. I don't know. Somehow I don't think so. But then why put it in the game? I mean, if this is based on the Eye of the Beholder 3 engine, which I think it is, then maybe all that stuff was just already in there. Like, all of the programming for the cleric spell list was just already in place, and they just kept that. But I don't think so, because the UI of this game is pretty different than the Eye of the Beholder games. Maybe I should try the magic mace again. Spiritual hammer doesn't seem to be doing that great. Alright, I'm going backwards. Now my strength is back to normal, so if that was causing me problems, that's no longer an issue. I mean, the problem with these Zills is that they're so fast, you have to back up 50 feet just to make sure you can hit them without getting hit. And if you're not paying attention, it's very easy to back up into just a hornet's nest. I wonder if that's a secret passage. Because, I mean, that's just going to be like a one square room. Maybe I should try avoiding some of these enemies. I mean, I don't need to fight all these things. Of course I am. Oh my god, that thing did so much damage to me. I am one level lower than I should be here. Well, once I hit the level where I can get restoration, like as an actual spell that I can memorize, not just a scroll, then that won't be such a big deal. I don't have another scroll restoration, do I? Because if I do, I should just go ahead and use it. I don't think so. Detect magic, yeah. Man, once I start running into monsters that have elemental attacks, it's going to throw a whole new wrench into the gears of my strategy. Oh, there's Mr. Minotaur. Unfortunately, I don't have my my Firestorm spell anymore. So let's Wand of Cold this dude. I don't know if... oops. Oh my god. Oh god.
For tomorrow you sail for the kingdom of Daggerfall.
I do not want to get hit by the Minotaur. Why? Oh. Okay, where is my flower key? Alright. No. I was really hoping there wouldn't be an enemy on the other side of that flower door. But there was. Alright. Where'd my wand go? Oh yeah, that's that balsa wand that doesn't do anything. I didn't drop the wand, did I? I don't know. I kind of panicked for a moment there. I mean, I don't have the wand, right? Or am I just missing it? I guess I dropped it somewhere. I was just freaking out. I had a Minotaur and a Zill and a Wraith. I wonder if the Minotaur heals, or if the monsters in general heal when I rest. Not really sure if they do or not. Oh, did I get him? Oh, nice. Whew. Okay, Pine Wand. Bracers that may or may not be better than what I have. And a Bamboo Wand. Well, that was worth it, I guess, if these wands are any good. Alright, that's a Wand of Magic Missiles. And that was a wand of Distance, which I think is just a Wand of Teleport. That looked like a teleportation effect if I ever saw one. Scrying Mirror, yes! Okay, that is so cool. Okay. Man, now I have to figure out what I want to use it on. Luckily, there is no cursed mirror. There's only the one mirror, and all it does is identify items. Wish I knew where I dropped that Wand of Cold. I don't know. I went all over the place trying to get away from those enemies. Alright, I should probably rest while I have a chance. Man, I didn't go up a level when I killed the Minotaur. That's a bummer. Oh, I forgot to cast Invisible Undead too. Damn it. I'll try that once I rest again. Let's see. Did the music stop? No. Okay. You! Asshole! I was just trying to get my shit together, and you come up and you hold me. Oh, wait, I did use Invisible Undead. I forget if it, Oh. So it was still in effect even after I rested. That's kind of neat. Alright, what did I not cast yet? Okay, I need to cast Negative Plane Protection. Oh my god. I was invisible to you guys. How do you know where I am? Maybe all that does is make it harder for them to hit me. Maybe they can see me. Like, they know where I am. They can smell me or something. But they just have a reduced chance to hit. That would kind of make sense with how invisibility works in 4th edition. Because in 4th edition, you can detect them by other means. Like, you can listen for them, make a perception check to try to spot them if they're invisible. Or not spot, but you know what I mean. But you're at a greatly reduced chance to hit. And the wraiths seemed to be a lot less likely to hit me when I'm under the effect of the spell. Which is nice. That's actually very helpful. Alright, is that Zilsto here? Man, things are getting pretty hairy. I'm not gonna mince words. I'm starting to get really worried. But you know, it's an early 90s RPG. I should have known what I was getting myself into. Okay. First things first. Well, if it was the first thing, I would have done it already. But I want to see what this book does. Tome of Leadership? I guess it's supposed to be and Influence Taken. Well, let's read that. Gain a point of charisma. I don't know how helpful that is, but I'm glad it happened. Okay, see what this ring does. Ring of Regeneration. Nice. I hadn't noticed that I was regenerating. That's a very good ring to have. Gadget ring. Ring of Strength. Is it a ring of strength? Oh yeah, that's the one that I knew what it did. Damn it, I wasted a use of my mirror. Oh well. Alright, see what this ring does. Ring of Feather Falling. Well, that's kind of cool. That means if I fall in a pit, I won't take any damage. Let's see. What else do I want to identify? Oh, it's a spiritual hammer +2, which means that does indicate... I didn't say this. I meant to say this in a couple videos ago. But that is apparently the bonus I'm getting from my level to the spiritual hammer, since that increased. All right, this balsa wand, I think, is the wand... Yeah, I've used all the charges. I think there's theoretically a way to recharge wands, but I've never encountered it. Alright, is there anything else I want to identify? I'm going to keep the Ring of Feather Falling on, because I don't think strength is that important to me. Okay, well, I should identify this cloak, and if it has a cool effect, then I should wear this instead of my chainmail, and then just cast Magical Vestment. Really, I should be casting Magical Vestment anyway, but... Cloak of Protection +1. I kind of don't want another buff spell. I want to have them to manage. But every little bit helps. Alright, so right now my armor class is 5. What's the best possible armor class I can have without magical vestment? Oh, I was looking for the shield. Alright, best armor class I can have is -1. Alright, so let's get magical vestment. I don't know what I'll trade out for it. I guess prayer. I don't know. I really want to have more negative plane protections than just 2. But I want to have the prayer effect and the magical vestment effect. They're both really helpful. Okay. So, let's rest. Alright, I want to hang on to that mirror. I don't necessarily want to identify anything else right now. Alright, so let's cast Magical Vestment. That makes my base armor class... see, I thought that wouldn't stack with the chainmail. Maybe I'm not high enough level yet for magical vestment to have that much of an effect. So with the shield, it's still -1. So I guess magical vestment isn't worth using just yet. So I don't want to use the cloak of protection. Maybe once I'm a higher level. Okay, I think I'm finally ready to actually keep playing the game. Let's cast prayer. Let's cast negative plane protection. I mean, unless the magical vestment it doesn't show up as an armor class bonus, unless it's just like a separate effect. I have no idea, actually. Alright, well, the monster has actually left me alone for 2 seconds, which was kind of nice. I don't have the key for this door, right? No. Not gonna worry about that wand. I actually don't know if there's a way to return wands in this game. There is in a lot of roguelikes, but I don't know if there's anything like that in this game. Because, I mean, logically, it would be a scroll, right? But there's no wizard spell that does that, or a cleric spell that recharges wands. So they'd have to make up a spell just to recharge the wand. So I'm pretty sure that once a wand is out of charges, it's done. And absolutely nothing. Just as I suspected. I shouldn't worry about rooms that are one square rooms. There's never anything in them. Am I still invisible to undead? I guess I am, because my portrait is still grayed out. Or darkened, rather. I don't think I've been hit by a wraith since I cast that. I'm glad I started using that. That's more helpful than I thought it would be. Of course. Man, I should have memorized Cure Paralysis and see if I can actually cast it when I'm held. Or prayed for, not memorized. Not gonna lump myself in with those dumb wizards. Oh! There's a secret passage there that I kind of blindly stumbled into. And there's one of those squares of confusion in that hallway. Not sure what that is, a magical trap of some kind. Hey, I could eat. So what do you want to eat for dinner? I don't know. I'm kind of in the mood for iron rations. Well, all we have are these rations. Just normal rations? Aw, man. Okay, this invisibility to undead spell is a lifesaver. Good job, Duke. I wish I had, like, a bowl of candy or something so I could reward myself with a piece of candy for realizing I should use invisibility to undead since I don't have my bell sitting on my desk to ring. Oh, great. Alright, let's give myself a little bit of the old healing juice. Man, I'm still not up a level? Man, having a level drain sucks. Maybe I should have vowed to restart whenever that happened. Wow, I've uncovered this much of the map, and I still haven't found the stairs down. It's either in this tiny little spot or this tiny little spot. Well, it's always in the last place you look. Because once you find it, you stop looking. Alright, so I need to go... Okay, zigzag up, go left, go down through the illusionary wall, keep going down, head right, and then, okay. Damn it! These traps and monsters are just going to get more and more nightmares the more I play, aren't they? The worst is yet to come. That's a reassuring thought. Alright, on the right track. Oh, you know what? I should identify that ion stone real quick. See what it does. Just out of curiosity. Yep, that was the last use of my mirror. Ion stone of petrification protection. What? That is not what's going on. I guess being held is different than being petrified. I thought they were mechanically the same thing. Maybe petrification is just instant death in this game, who knows. Well guys, that'll do it for level 5. And we immediately have a... Oh, great. Okay, well, we will deal with these ghosts in tomorrow's video. Hope you've had fun. I have, despite my belly aching, and we have a lot of trials and hardships to overcome. But we'll get through this together, you and I. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.